hundreds of school support staff will walk off the job tomorrow to protest planned education cuts. Some will confront the Premier tonight at a community cabinet meeting in Scarborough. Tegan Sapwell's there and joins us live. Tegan, what's the mood like?
Well, Nerelda, education support staff and union representatives started arriving here a short time ago. They're hoping to confront Colin Barnett about planned cuts to education and also to ask him if he'll attend tomorrow's rally so that he can explain to workers why the cuts are necessary. Now, today the government was urging workers not to follow through with industrial action, but it doesn't look like they'll get off the hook that easily.
With industrial action looming, Education Minister Peter Collier seemed to welcome distraction from the tough questions.
No, I don't like the notion of strikes, obviously, as a former talkie and an Education Minister. I really don't like that. I think that... It's my mum.
Barnhu was standing firm on the education reforms, which would see at least 350 support staff axed.
I urge them... I plead with them, please don't think about industrial action. I don't think it's for the benefit of anyone.
Hundreds of education assistants and other support staff will walk off the job tomorrow at midday for a rally at Parliament House. The union representing the workers says its members won't be backing down.
It'll have an impact for one day, whereas the cuts that Premier Barnett are proposing will have an impact, you know, every day of the school year.
Teachers also plan to rally at Parliament at 4 o'clock. Their stop work meeting won't affect students. The growing resentment, a win for Labor, which today urged voters to take their frustrations with Colin Barnett out on Tony Abbott at the federal election.
Mr Barnett and the Liberals need to learn you can't just break promises, you can't just say one thing before an election and do another thing afterwards.
He certainly hasn't made my job any harder.
Tegan Sapwell, 10 News.